I'm drowning, like I'm running out of air. Hello, Mr. Golnick and classmates. Today we're gonna present our country, PILA. So Piper and I came up with the name PILA because it's a combination of our names, Paola and Piper. So first off, I'm gonna be explaining a little bit about the national languages. The national languages include Spanish, English, and Pilanese, which is a combination of English, Spanish, and French. So here's an example of how the language would sound like. So here's a sentence. Let's go to the beach with Thomas and Matt. So that would translate to Vamos a la beach avec Tomás y Matt. And there's also an example of slang, of Pilanese slang, and it's Fipa Fet, which translates to party. So now I'm gonna be talking about the main source of income.
So I had to change my working space from my phone to my computer, so that's why the change of scenery. But now, as I said before, I'm gonna be talking about the main source of income in PILA. PILA's main source of income is all due to the agriculture, which is a practice of cultivating plants and livestock, but there's also a local farm where we raise animals, which is called the Pila Vila. And by raising just a few heads of cattle each year, it can provide us with a good bonus income since beef and dairy products are always in demand. Also, we're slowly but surely trying to get involved in the organic farming business as well as in the alternative or meat substitute business. Yet, it's still a working process due to the fact that animal farming is our main source of income after all, so it's gonna take us a lot of time to like make that big change, but slowly but surely we're gonna get there. Now I'm gonna be talking about the type of education that people will see in PILA. So the type of education that you would see is formal education, which refers to the structured education system that runs from primary, or as some other countries call it, nursery school, to university, and it includes specialized programs for vocational, technical, and professional training, which will prepare you for anything in life. Now, the relationship with other countries. So PILA's relationship with other countries is very good. They share their agricultural system with these countries, and in other words, they have a good relationship with their sister countries. They have an exporting system, and they all get to communicate very well and get to evolve as a country and be very skilled when it comes to communicating, which is amazing, because to keep a good relationship you have to communicate and you have to be good at communicating. Now the last thing I'm going to be talking about is about the structure of government. And the structure of PILA's government is based on the federal system. And federalism is a system of government in which the same territory is controlled by two levels of government. So generally, there is an overarching national government that is responsible for the broader governance of larger territorial areas. And then there's the smaller subdivision states and cities that govern the issues of local concern. So those are the two levels. So now I'm going to leave you guys with Piper, and she's going to be explaining the official stance of migration, how the indigenous people are treated, what people in PILA do for recreation, and day in the life, as well as the national anthem.
Recreation. There is a big amusement park in the outsides of PILA. It is called the Bright Blue Water Amusement Park. The park is not in the capital, though. It's about 30 minutes away in car. There is also a local soccer team called the PILA CF. The people in PILA love soccer to watch and play it. There are also many beach activities brought to you by the Romero company. How are the indigenous people treated? Indigenous people are often marginalized and face discrimination in countries' legal systems, leaving them even more vulnerable to violence and abuse. Not in PILA, though. We are advocating for them in every possible way. We have organizations as well as support groups. As a community, we are helping the indigenous people here in PILA. feel comfortable and safe as well as normal. We are proud to say that there is peace in PILA. We appreciate and admire their culture. So our national anthem. Our national anthem is, "Far we have grown as a country, we fight the war for our people. The power we have when we come together can unite, can build peace, so we then can be equal. We march for our rights and cry for our land because it's as beautiful as one can be. The price we have obtained, the more we want them. One day we will get there, you will see. The man in the house has screamed towards the sea, aiming at a boat we have seen. The scream translated to freedom, yes, the freedom we need. As that's what we've got after years and years of believing, you see." Official stance of migration. PILA's official stance of migration is moderate. As long as the people migrating or entering the country follow all the requirements, they will not have any consequences. PILA is the only country that doesn't mandate immigration detention for all unlawful arrivals, including those seeking protection as refugees. So a day in the life in PILA is probably going to the beach, because there's many beaches in PILA. They spend a lot of their time at the beach. This includes businessmen, mothers, children, teachers, everyone. And beside the beach, people have their normal life, including going to school, college, or going to work. Thank you for watching. I hope you come visit soon.